Terry.
Hey, Fiona.
In her eyes, you're a ridiculous peasant. Kill her, and you will discover what it feels like to be truly alive.
Mr. Whiskers, he makes me do bad things.
You totally stopped taking the pills, didn't you?
Totally.
An interesting thing to note about the new movie, The Voices, starring Ryan Reynolds, is that he states the following.
You like trivia?
Yes.
I got a good one, okay. There's tons of angels in the Bible, but only four of them have names, three of which are Michael, Raphael, and Gabriel. Who's the fourth?
You're not getting all religious on me, are you, Joe?
No, this is fun. Come on, guess. Who's the fourth?
I don't know. Freddy the angel.
No, not Freddy. You know this. You know his name, I promise you. You're forgetting one thing. You're forgetting that he's an angel.
Jerry, kill me. I want to die. Take your knife and cut my throat.
Don't worry, I'll help you.
What? No, no, Jerry!
I gotta do it, I gotta do it! The fourth angel is Lucifer. Lucifer is an angel, a fallen angel. Fiona! Fiona! He asked me to do it! Fiona, don't run! You'll get lost! Fiona!
Now, of course, if you're getting your theology from Hollywood, you're already in trouble. But, indeed, many people do get their theology from Hollywood. And the thing is the theology correct? Because since it's a fictional movie, the writers really should have invented some kind of mythology. And he could say, well, within this certain mythology, there's these kind of beings and what have you. But his reference is specifically to the Bible. And it'll be interesting to see how many people even bother commenting on this. I know many people won't because they just say, hey, it's a movie, who cares? But the issue is that the Bible actually only gives us the name of three angels and maybe four. One is Michael, and you can find that in Daniel 10:21, Daniel 12:1, Jude 9, and Revelation 12:7-9. Then there's Gabriel, Daniel 8:16, Daniel 9:21, Luke, and also in Luke 1:26-38. Now, the third is one whose name in Hebrew is Abaddon, and in Greek, Apollyon. This is the angel of the bottomless pit in Revelation 9:1-1. Now, the fourth, the possible one, is one called Wormwood. Now, this assumes that since Revelation 1 states that, quote-unquote, stars are the angels, so it provides symbolism and interprets the symbolism or defines it, within this certain symbolic context, then maybe Revelation 8:10-11 seems to be identifying such one, stating that there fell a great star from heaven, burning as if it were a lamp, and the name of the star is called Wormwood. Now, the issue with Lucifer is that, for one, that particular title is an eventual transliteration or interpretation that comes from a Latin translation. That would be a whole video in and of itself. The point being that within this context, Lucifer, or Satan, or the devil, or that old serpent, is not an angel, is not a fallen angel. He is a cherub, as per Ezekiel 28:14. And angels and cherubs are different categories of being. For instance, humans and bovines are different categories of being, even though we both live upon the earth. Angels and cherubs look different and have different job functions. So for example, biblically, angels look just like human males. They do not have wings, and for what it's worth, they also don't have halos. And their job is messengers. That's literally what angel means. Cherubs have four wings, four faces, that of a man, that of a lion, that of an eagle or a vulture, and that of an ox or a bull. They have hoof-like feet, and they also... Well, their bodies are not described for us, whether they're humanoid or not. Perhaps they are. They have some kind of hand-like prehensile appendage under each wing. And their job is generally defined within scholarly literature as being throne guardians. So very different beings. And that's the kind of stuff you get if you get your theology from Hollywood. It's just complete inaccuracy. So there it is. Keep your eye out always for what you're being told, how you're being told it, and the reason for why you're being told it. When you're watching a movie, everything is said for a reason. Someone conceived of an idea. They wrote the script. The script was reviewed. The script was edited. The script was discussed. Experts are brought in to do lighting and scenery and settings. And everything you see in a movie is there for a reason. It doesn't necessarily have to be some kind of evil conspiratorial reason, but it's there for a reason. And you're being told things such as these for a reason. Maybe the writer of this particular part of the script just made an assumption, or, well, you can guess by yourself for whatever the reason was. The fact is that it's inaccurate, and here's the evidence.